Not the recognition I deserve if I keep clowning around in those Commedia shows.
Yes, but Shakespeare doesn't pay shit. So we're doing a Commedia show. See? Harlequin on the Moon reboot. What'd you say?
What do I say? I said last time we did this, it was a catastrophe. Half of the actors quit. Huh? So how are we gonna do the show? There's only two of us left.
Yes, no.
Now is the winter.
I found another actor. One of the actresses is wonderful. She's actually your daughter.
Ha!
Yes.
My daughter. Great.
Yes. Sophia!
She's wonderful. Yes, she's a natural talent.
Yeah, she's a natural talent for messing things up.
Je n'ai pas eu ton anglais, mon vernis. Je suis pas prête. Qu'est-ce que tu
fais? See? She can't even speak English.
I speak English. Mais pas à toi.
Takes this from her mother.
Toujours ça, ma mère, ma mère.
Okay, let's calm down here. Samia, we're gonna work together, okay? We're professional, we can do this. So, Guy, your name will be on the poster in huge letters.
Yeah, it better be, yeah.
Samia, I found the fourth actress. He's actually quite cool. Il est très mignon. Alors, je suis à la plage Antibes et...
Il est mignon, c'est vrai, les dirapos.
Alors, en fait, moi, je me paye. Et puis il était en speedo, et je me suis dit, non, il a toutes les qualités pour être un acteur. Ça, c'est un acteur. So, I saw that you're single, right? So, yes, I found my fourth actor.
Une soca pizza, une marguerite, et une. Quatre fromages, ça fera 27 €. Who calls for pizza?
That's him! That's the fourth actor!
Non, c'est pas vrai!
Oh, God!
Toi!
Non, mais toi, non, mais c'est pas vrai!
C'est elle, la comédienne super talentueuse, charmante!
Moi, je chope avec
elle! Sorcière!
Vous connaissez?
Je me suis. Six mois que j'ai passé avec elle!
Invivable, insupportable!
That's it. My career is going down the toilet right now.
Okay, well,
I know. I'll settle this.
Okay.
I can do Richard III, I know all the parts. Now is the winter of our discontent.
No, I know.
Moi, je viens là pour prendre du plaisir, hein, si c'est pour...
We are in a democracy, still. So, we're gonna vote, right? Who wants to see Richard III with just one guy for 4 hours?
I.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. You're so kind. Don't be there. See, the other guy there.
No. Who wants to see Harlequin!
Okay, what kind of democracy is this?
No, we're gonna get it.
Fine, I'll go back to my kingdom.
Game of Thrones, I tell you. Okay, so we're doing Harlequin on the Moon. Good choice. So, we're gonna have fantastic lovers. Look how cute they are. Come on, the lovers, we love them.
Amazing.
Oh, this is so adorable. Great. So as promised, we'll do Harlequin.
brisée. Stupendous.
Ah! Ah! Incredible!
Proportions.
And I can taste the sausage of historical proportion.
Anything I should know?
Oh, yes, yes, in the entire world. No, but I have to keep it a secret for now.
A secret? Mm-hmm. You can tell me. I should keep it to myself. Cross my heart and hope to die. Let's see if it's a secret worth eating. Worth eating.
Well, you have to understand, Harlequin, this has to be the greatest scientific accomplishment since at least Galileo.
Galileo, Figaro, Physico!
No! After careful observation, I have determined that... Are you ready for this?
As ready as macaroni! As ready as can be.
Oh, well, Harlequin, my boy...
Yes!
There are men on the moon.
And women too?
Yes, I'm sure. Crowd of people scurrying around on the surface of the moon.
That is wonderful news.
Yes.
I don't know why you're so excited about this, but if it's good for him, it's good for me. Wow, I have stunned. Desk goal for a celebration. How about a large meal? For instance, macaroni.
No, not yet. Yes, scientists cannot make claims casually. We need solid proof. Yes, and this telescope is nice, but it's just not powerful enough for me to see the surface of the moon clearly. Yes.
Who cares? You already made a major breakthrough.
Yes.
Dottore, you're a hero.
Yes. I've already made plans to acquire a new, more powerful telescope.
How long is this going to take? My macaroni is getting cold.
Well, good telescopes are expensive.
Ugh.
And of course, they come from Holland. Ugh. Yeah, you can't get just one like that. Just. A new telescope very soon. As soon as I can marry off my daughter Eularia.
What? What does marrying off your daughter Eularia have anything to do with getting a new telescope? This is even crazier than people on the moon.
Well, for starters, someone is already interested in her.
I am sure. And?
And that someone happens to be very wealthy.
So, isn't it the custom that the father, you, give the daughter some money in order to get her married? You know the dowry?
No. Not when the groom is also very old and very sick. Yes. In this case, he will pay through the nose to marry my daughter, and I will get a brand new telescope. Everybody is happy.
Maybe not, Eularia. What if
Eulalia does not agree to this business deal. I mean, this wonderful marriage.
What do you mean, not agree? This is my daughter. She has no choice.
You have to like it when things are so simple.
Well, in any case, I've already made contact. Yes, with a Dutch lensmaker. He makes the most wonderful telescopes. Yes, yes. And I'm expecting an answer from him any time now. Yeah? Yeah. So soon, Harlequin, soon. Soon. I will be the most celebrated astronomer in all of Europe.
And I will be the hungriest Harlequin in all of Europe.
So go talk to Eulalia and tell her that she should prepare for a wedding. I'm going to go to the post office to see if my letter from Holland has already arrived.
If he gets his telescope, I'll get my macaron. Eulalia, she gets an old, ugly husband.
Oh!
There might be a problem in all of this, but I'm not quite sure what they did. Oh! Good problem, as a right.
I can't stand it anymore. I need a man. No.
Oh. She might get a wish in a
way. Oh, the queen, well met.
Yeah. You are a man?
Yep. You can help me find a man.
What would you do with him?
I don't know the usual.
I know! What? Sex!
No! My age! Yeah! I need to find a way to leave this place. My father makes me crazy with his scientific experiments. I want Harlequin, a normal life, in a normal home.
And marriage is going to give you that?
What do I know? I am a comedian.
You got a point. Do you have anyone in mind?
Well, not really. I'm a girl.
What about him, for instance?
Yeah.
Hey.
Baluardo de Hoboken?
Depends! Who wants to know?
The
There's a letter. A letter for him. From abroad.
I'm right here.
It's an urgent letter.
He looks honest, but you have to be careful in case it's someone coming to collect the debt.
So, am I at the home of the doctor?
Depends. What the letter is about?
How should I know? I just brought here.
You haven't read it?
No, I'm paid to deliver the letters, not to read them.
Why not?
That's a very good question. You should ask my employer, I have no idea.
Well, let me tell you, you will make a much better job of it if you already know what it is that you are delivering.
It's actually a great idea. Still, is this the home of the dottore? Or... Yes.
I have to know what the letter is about before I decide if it is or not.
It doesn't work that way. Are you the dottore? Are you working for the dottore? Listen. If you are not.
Oh! My father is nowhere to be found! And
back now.
thing.
Not so fast! We may need it in case we run into a problem later, and it might be better for us if Dottore does not receive the letter.
Why?
We may need it when we get a problem letter, and we will have a problem letter? Not now, in a couple of scenes from now, when we do have a problem.
It's kind of complicated.
You already have a plan for this problem? Not yet.
Wait!
But I will.
I just realized I was supposed to deliver the letter without them reading them. Am I going to have a problem?
Yeah. Hey.
That you are getting to be the age at which girls are starting to become women.
Did you say so, Father?
And when young girls start to become women, they begin to feel a yearning. Yes, a desire. An urge to, get married!
You should say so, Father.
Yeah. So, there's something very important that I need to tell you about the good qualities that make for an ideal husband.
Oh, I would love to hear your ideas about that, Father.
Oh, yes. Well, so there is one quality that counts above all others. He has to be rich.
In addition, he has to be intelligent.
In addition, he has to be quite wealthy.
It doesn't hurt if he is attentive.
Yeah, and of course it doesn't hurt if he's a multimillionaire.
Oh, Father, yeah? It pleases me to tell you that such a perfect man exists.
Oh, yes, indeed. But I haven't told you about him yet.
Oh, yes, but as the fate would have it, I already met him. Oh, purely by accident, Father. But when I saw him, I knew immediately he was the one.
Oh, what a fortuitous coincidence. Pantalone is already in town, and I didn't know it.
So, Father, yes. We can be married as soon as the arrangements are made.
Yes. The sooner, the better. This way, I can get my brand new telescope.
What does your telescope have to do with my wedding?
Never mind. It's none of your concern.
I am the one getting married, so perhaps I should know about this new, very powerful Dutch telescope.
Wait a minute. How do you know that it is supposed to be a Dutch telescope?
Oh, I learned it from my future.
Pantalone told you about it? How does he even know about it?
Who is Pantalone?
Your future husband, of course!
My future husband is... Cynthia!
Who the heck is Cynthia?
Young, handsome, incredibly intelligent and head-tempting, but I am going to...
Is he also incredibly rich?
I don't think so.
Okay, then just to be on the safe side, you'll marry Pantalone all this
time. I don't even know him.
But all you need to know is that he's extremely wealthy.
Does he have any other quality you want to mention?
Oh yes, qualities, please. Yes, 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 yes. He's also very old. Yes, and not in very good health either. So he won't bother you too long.
Honey, you want to marry me to an old man with one foot in the grave just to get money for the telescope?
Oh, money. Money. We scientists do not care about money, only about knowledge. But I need to make new discoveries, and that costs money, therefore you will marry Pantalone. Podera demonstrando.
If I understand correctly, you want more this new superb telescope than you want me to marry Pantalone.
Yes!
So if I could provide you with this superb telescope somehow, you would let me marry Cynthia instead.
Yes! I don't care if you marry Pantalone, Cynthia, or Rocky Balboa, as long as you are happy.
Oh, father!
I get my telescope.
You are such a reasonable man, dear father.
Yes. But time is of the essence, and I need to start making arrangements for the wedding now. Mm-hmm.
So, father, now I will go to my room.
Mm-hmm.
Check. Let me know how it goes.
Yes. I'm really fortunate to have such an accommodating daughter. Yes, most young girls would be upset to have to marry an old, sick, and ugly man just for money. But I think it's all going to turn out for the better. All the quick?
Up.
Are you up?
No. Dinner time.
Present it then. Are you sure you want to marry that guy? Get up, girl.
I will take my chances.
Well then. From where? Does Dr. Ray expect to get his new contraption?
Contraption? Leave contraption land!
No! Whole land!
Oh. I like contraption land.
More specific. The very telescope that Dr. Ray dreams of is going to be delivered by a Dutch lens maker, an opticien hollandais.
L'opticien hollandais? Now that rings a bell!
No! I don't see where this is going. How do we produce a famous Dutch lens maker? Has Dr. Ray seen the Dutch lens maker? No! Has Dr. Ray seen?
Thank you.
No! Ergo, seen you will make a perfect Dutch lens maker.
Me?
A few props will. First, we need the Dutch mustache. very Dutch.
Nope, I don't feel very Dutch.
Now we need the Dutch hat. Very Dutch.
No, no, still nothing.
We need the Dutch phrase book. Learn a few words from it, huh?
Right. De gebouwen in de stad zijn prachtig.
Is dat Dutch enough?
All right. We gotta get ready. We wait until Dutch is asleep, and then we steal the pen.
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream, making the cutest that I've ever seen. Give me 2 lenses for an astronova, and tell him that his lonesome night's not over. Sandman, I'm so sleepy, I need my bed and my soft teddy. So please turn on your magic beam, Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Mr. Sandman, I'm so sleepy, I need my bed and my soft teddy, so please turn on your magic beam. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream, dream, dream. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream.
Where's my telescope? Did you see my telescope?
No. Harlequin!
Oh, he's alive!
Now, come here, yeah!
Yes, see you, Victor.
Where is my telescope?
It's right here.
Now, I don't see it.
Well, put on your glasses.
I do not see it because it is not here.
Oh, then you must have put it away last night.
What would I do such a thing?
To prevent thief from stealing it.
Well, I didn't put it away last night.
Then thief must have taken it. Then order at the box for you.
That's so rough. Is that all you have to say for your defense?
No, I have something else to say for my defense. I promise that you will not be missing until now. But there is someone at the door that's going to change all of that.
Oh, and who could that be?
I don't know, a certain Dutch lensmaker.
Oh, Van Lovenhoek?
Himself!
Oh, what a coincidence.
He's right outside. Would you like me to bring him in?
Well, of course! You'll get in! Better than I thought!
Wait, it's all dark now.
Wait, the cloth! You still have it over your head. You need to remove the cloth.
Oh, yes, the cloth. Ah, that's
Mr. Van Lovenhoy! Come here!
Your contraption is indeed wonderful! Terrific! I wanted!
Telegram, did you make him understand that I cannot pay for it just now?
Oh, yes, he said he will normally charge you 4,000 guilder for it. 4,000 guilder.
4,000 guilders? Holy crap, that's a lot of money.
How much is that in US dollars?
It depends if Trump is impeached or not, because there is a strong possibility, Mikey. If so, the Wall Street market is going to go down.
Now that is suspicious. Well, trade it for what? For what? Huh? The song. Oh, I know. My entire house.
No.
No. Oh. Ah, I get it. My library of rare science books.
Niche. No.
What then?
He wants to trade it with something you were going to get rid of anyway.
Oh. My old overcoat? He's willing to trade a 4,000 guilder telescope for an old tattered coat? I don't believe it.
Niche.
No.
What?
You donor, you Laria.
Oh, but is not for sale or trade.
No. Well, you were going to marry her for money for your telescope anyway.
Well, as a manner of speaking.
Well, this seems your transaction, in a manner of speaking.
She's never even seen this man.
She has not even seen Pantalone either, and that was not going to stop you.
True. But how will they communicate? Doesn't speak Dutch.
Who does? Besides, they will argue much less than the average married couple.
You've got a point there.
Yeah, so what do you say?
Well, I don't know exactly why, but I think there is something slightly suspicious about it. And I'll tell you what, I'll think about it. Just make sure you leave the telescope right here.
Is that all right? Mr. Von Lulu is actually very hungry. He traveled all the way from Holland and he likes macaroni very much.
You take him to lunch.
Wonderful. Unfortunately, the trattoria doesn't give macaroni for free.
And I should pay for it?
Well, since you're a guest, after all.
Oh, I guess. Macaroni. Here. All right, and don't spend it all in one place. There you go.
You didn't put anything.
I did? Oh. All right, there you go. I hope this extravagance is worth it.
Extravagance? Getting money from the Doctor is like shaving an egg. Thank you, Magnificent.
get Eulalia.
Eulalia!
Yes. I wrote him a letter, but he goes faster when we call. Ah, si, pronto.
Pronto!
Ah, yes, 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 good. Good, 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 good. I was thinking that the wedding has to take place very soon, huh?
Ah, si, yeah. The wedding, Eulalia, bellezza.
Are you still alive? You good?
De sempre, sempre.
You can still get it up? Yes. It's perfect, but I've got news for you. Yes, there's a new suitor.
What?
A new suitor, a young, strapping Dutchman. Yes.
Oh, d'accordo. Vieni, vieni, vieni da qua.
I'm afraid that the price is going to go up.
Ah, money, money, money. In the rich man's world.
The Dutch love maker. Father! Father! Oh, Father! So, Father.
Yes. Excellent news! Things are moving quickly, even quicker than I thought.
Tell me more!
Yes, well, there. My new telescope has just arrived, and isn't it beautiful?
Yes, but I was asking about my marriage.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Well, you see, this telescope changes everything. Yes, well, I can't stop right here now. I have to build an entire observatory. Yes. Scientists from all over the world will flock to work with me. I will be the most celebrated scientist in all of the world. Forget Galileo.
Yes, but Father, at the risk of repeating myself, I'm asking about my marriage.
Yes, your marriage to Pantalone must happen very soon.
To Pantalone?
Well, yeah, of course to Pantalone. What do you think? He will pay for this telescope. He will pay for the observatory. He will pay for everything! Just to get you.
And I should take this as a compliment?
Yes! You'll thank me later. I am sparing you a lifetime of having to speak Dutch. Ta-ta!
Tu pantalone?
So well.
Yes, but... Oh,
I understand. You poor little thing. Let me explain. You're not gonna get married to me. Of course. You're gonna get married to Van Leeuwenhoek.
Yes, I remember Van Leeuwenhoek.
But what you don't understand, nor your father, is that Van Leeuwenhoek is me.
Yes,
you poor little
thing. Actually, my father wants to marry me to Pantalone.
Wait, that's not me.
So quick. Hello, lovebird.
Hey, Harlequin, come here. I don't understand your plan. I was supposed to be married, and now she's getting married to Pantalone.
Oh, that was definitely not my plan.
What happened? No, the telescope is not enough. It won't fit an entire observatory.
An observatory? Wow. That is crazy. Oh, well. Better luck next time.
Hey! Come back! Harlequin!
Where do you think you are going?
Oh, I have important business to conduct.
Not today.
Wow. I want to take a nap.
Oh, no, you are not taking a nap until we have a new plan.
But what is a good dinner without a nap afterwards? Oh, I have a plan. No, I don't. You see, I'm very clever when I'm hungry. Now that I have eaten so much, perhaps you could be out of it. Be motivated by something else. Something like fear, for instance.
Fear?
Yeah.
Fear of what?
Fear of me!
Now, Harlequin, listen to me very carefully. If you do not help us get married, you will never, ever, ever eat again.
Never, ever eat again. Ha! We need a plan!
See? It's quite simple.
How well do you think of it, Einstein?
Hey, you're supposed to be the clever one. After all, I am Cynthia. The handsome.
And I am the don't you suck.
Darling, we got it.
Yes.
So,
I have a plan. You two will, you're gonna wear another costume.
Another costume?
Yes.
But it didn't work last time.
Well, it would be a different costume.
Oh!
Can you handle a sword?
Well, of course.
Perfect! You two will pose as Spadaccini.
Spadaccini?
The hired killer. You will scare Dottore into changing his mind. Just enough, let me marry Van Lovenhoek.
What? How could you do this to me? You were supposed to marry me, not Van Lovenhoek!
You are Van Lovenhoek!
Oh, this is very complicated. Do you have any kind of script I could follow?
A script? I just made this up!
Oh, so smart.
So, go get ready at the Spadaccini, and don't kill the turret. He has not paid me yet.
Non, ça ne craint pas. Non, 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 il n'y a pas de problème. Attends, pense quoi qu'il est bien,
ce reste, non? Oh, attends, regarde, regarde. Oh,
il te
va
comme un gant.
Oh, ouais.
Oh, on dirait une sorcière, t'es laide.
Ah, mais
toi,
t'as toujours le mot super méchant.
Toi, toujours 0 une autre, mais ça, ça
ne
change pas.
Hein, c'est pas. Et puis, tu te la pètes, là, comme ça, avec ta veste.
Mais attends, elle n'est pas trop classe, la veste.
Oh, non,
regarde,
elle
n'est
pas
classe, la veste.
Il y a une grande épée, elle est trop bien cette grande épée.
Allez, passe.
Hop. Non. Pourquoi tu prends la grande épée? Ça peut être moi aussi.
Ça vient, s'il te plaît. C'est de la comédia, là. C'est bon, hein. On prend le gros gars, là. Il fait ah ah ah. Il fait des gros bruits, les gens, ils sont contents. Et la fille, elle fait la petite amoureuse.
Ah non, moi, je suis pas d'accord. Je suis pas d'accord parce que moi, c'est bien parce que je suis une petite nana que je vais avoir la grande. Et puis, moi, Zorro, j'adorais quand j'étais petite.
Non mais Samia peut-être, mais là l'épée de Zorro elle est plus grande que toi. Ça va pas marcher. Allez, on s'habille, voilà. On va rentrer sur scène parce que Guy nous attend. Voilà. Hop. Est-ce qu'elle est prête?
Presque.
Alors, je monte sur scène, tu me suis, tu dis rien, c'est
bon. Non, y a pas moyen, moi je vais sur scène, je parle, hein. C'est comme ça. Hein.
Je peux pas parler, t'es la fille de Baloardo. Alors, c'est le père, donc il va reconnaître la voix de sa fille. Ça veut dire que je te le dis, c'est ma scène, c'est mon air de gloire. Alors,
greetings.
Are you the Dr. Valuardo de Hoboken?
Yes.
Yes. Ah. Io sono Luigi Spezzamonti. And this is my brother, Vito. But geez, he's a mutant.
Vito!
Lariba, he's a little simple.
Oh, yes. So, are we acquainted?
Oh, you might say that, yes. Oh. See, our cousin was supposed to marry your beautiful daughter.
Vito,
your...
Vito!
Yes. You must be from Pantalone's family. Huh? You have come from Venice for the wedding.
Pantalone? Yeah. Not Pantalone. We came all the way from Sicilia.
Oh. Sicilia.
For the funeral.
Accidenti. Pantalone is dead.
Oh, no. Oh. For your funeral.
Sicilia.
I'm not dead.
No, don't worry. Ah, it will only take 1 minute. Yeah.
What do you want to kill me? Is it for money? I give it all to you, my entire fortune. Yes. Here it is. That's all I have. My entire
right.
fortune.
Let's do this.
Vito!
No. No. We Sicilians cannot accept the money. Because we came per l'onore, l'onore della famiglia.
Etzia!
You had promised your daughter to her cousin, and now you wanna renege on your pledge. Very bad.
But, so you're a cousin with Van Lovenhoy? Hmm? But you're not even Dutch!
Vedete? È una grande famiglia!
Sicilia!
Sì, siamo la parte siciliana della famiglia olandese dei Van Lovenhoek. And we Sicilians specialize in offing the people who create trouble. Are you going to create trouble? Then defend yourself!
No, I can't defend myself, I don't carry a weapon!
Right, you know.
A weapon!
Yes.
Now that we are all ready...
Wait, don't you have something else? Like, I don't know, a machine gun, a hand grenade, a bazooka or something?
Oh, stop the thing and start dying!
Wait, maybe we can reach some sort of agreement.
No agreement. Only the killing! The killing! And we'll kill!
Vito!
We will not kill! No! Because see the right hand and the left hand dance together. And the ring on the... Oh! If you put a ring on it! Put a ring on it! Let me do it. Dottor! Possiamo partire? Ma il cugino deve sposare la tua figlia.
Oh, you want your cousin Van Lovenhoek to marry my daughter? Fine, he can have it. I consent.
Dottor, benvenuti nella famiglia!
Vito!
Vito!
We will keep an eye on you. Come, Vito.
Vito!
Oh, this can't go on anymore! We need to put an end to this right away. Harlequin! Come here! We need to get a hold of Pantalone post! Haste!
What's the rush?
The wedding. It has to happen right now.
But what about
Van Lovenhoek? I know, he's a very nice man and everything, but he just didn't bring enough money and all his... And besides... I don't like his Sicilian cousins one bit!
I guess we need yet another plan. Mistress, you like it?
Yeah! I love you!
calculation.
The plan worked out perfectly.
It did!
Yeah! And
then it did not!
Wait, what?
Dottore was so scared that now he wants you to be married to Pantalone as soon as possible.
As soon as possible!
Pantalone? Can we go and threaten him too?
You've done enough.
I enjoyed it.
We know. Now we need something more convincing.
Oh, we expect you have a new plan.
It's easy as pie. You two will pose as Selenites.
Oh, yeah, Selenites.
I cannot do that. I'm already posing as a Hollandaise, a Sicilian, and now you want me to pose as a... what exactly?
A Selenite. The people of the moon, remember?
Oh, right. And so, what do they look like?
Well, just wear anything you want. Be as colorful and bizarre.
Colorful and bizarre?
But make sure Dr. Ray does not recognize you, huh?
Of course not.
Oh, what should we do?
I cannot tell you.
Why not?
The suspense. Think of the audience. I really have to tell them everything. And now, I need some help. You see, I don't have really good actors to work with me, so... Here's a volunteer. Thank you, sir. So you keep this very carefully with you. And when I call you... Dottore! Dottore!
What now?
Come here, please. Come here, please. I was thinking, perhaps there is something more that you would like than a new telescope or an observatory.
Well, I sincerely doubt it.
Well, I was thinking, how about getting a closer look, a much, much closer look at the people of the moon?
Well, just how much, much, much closer?
How about meeting them in person?
You're drunk.
No. You see, Dottore, I have been to the moon myself.
But actually, you are drunk.
No. Let me see. I'm going to tell you the story on how I went to the moon. Oh. Can I help you? Just right there.
That should be good. Oh, great. Puppet theater. I can hear it shot.
You see, Dottore? Mm. It all happened by accident, really.
I'm sure it did.
Yes, one day. Hello!
It is a puppet show.
It is me!
I think they got it.
One day, I went to the market to purchase a goose. Drop! Oh, my dinner. Come here. On my way back, I was attacked by an eagle. He snapped away my goose.
This story before, yes, except it wasn't a goose, it was a duck. And it wasn't an eagle either, it was a vulture. Yeah. Yes, and the character, if I remember clearly, it was what?
The eagle.
Oh, yeah.
Lifted me off the ground. Up into the sky.
This is the most ridiculous doll tale I've ever heard in my life.
Wait!
Oh, there's more, right?
The eagle caught a thermal current, and we rose above the sky, into the clouds, up into the stratosphere! Oh. Until finally, the eagle released me, and I fell down! Wow!
So you fell down all the way from the stratosphere. That's several thousand miles. How's that possible?
No.
It doesn't make a lot of sense.
I fell up.
You fell up?
To the moon.
Well, that makes even less sense.
Well,
the moon is made out of cheese?
Of course I have. What kind of a scientist do you think I am?
Well, I can confirm it. The moon is made out of cheese. Emma Teller, I would say.
Oh, and?
I was a curiosity on the moon. The selenites asked me all sort of questions.
Who do you work for?
And I said, what? Senor Dottore Barodo, of course. And they all went,
Barodo, Barodo.
They knew me.
Knew you? Ah, they worship you. You are a celebrity over there. They were so happy that they insisted that I met their emperor.
An emperor? On the moon?
Yes, of course. You see, here we have King Macron the First, and on the moon, we have an emperor.
I guess people need some form of government. That makes sense.
The emperor was so impressed to finally meet someone who knew the great Dottore Barodo that he insisted that I was sent back to Earth with a group of Selenites.
Selenites? The inhabitants of the moon?
And guess what?
What?
Here they are! This
we get it on most every night. When that moon is big and bright, it's a supernatural delight.
Is she supposed to get hitched?
Yes, of course. Yes, she's going to be married to Signor Pantalone de Bisognosi.
Oh, no!
What's so funny?
No way, you lie. Pantalone is scoring a fox like you.
He's not worthy. Not worthy.
Pantalone is just about the richest man in all of Venice. How can you beat that?
Don't sweat it.
We can beat it.
Beat it. Beat it. Beat it. No one.
Beat it.
Beat
it.
They have a better deal to offer.
Huh?
You see, the Emperor of the Moon has a son he needs to be married, and you have a daughter he needs to be married. They want to form an alliance with the people of Earth. Voila.
Oh, but,
what?
Eulalia, yeah? She's no princess.
Well, she'd be the princess of the moon, imagine that.
Oh, great. But what's in it for me?
Oh, you be the greatest scientist in all of the history of humanity.
Ah, I like that.
So, dottore.
Yeah?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
To meet the moon prince!
Sure, we can have a wedding if you want and everything, but that takes, you know, time and preparation, and besides, the moon prince, he's in the moon, he's not even here yet.
Oh, well, actually... They figure it would be quicker to send the moon prince right away.
Instant karma, the moon prince. So,
these people look really, really well organized.
What do you say?
Yeah, I said, okay, good. So you should get Eulalia then.
Oh, okay. And Mrs. Eulalia, your husband has arrived.
Oh, yeah, I have a friend. Yeah, my husband.
Yes.
Oh,
this is my husband. It doesn't look like as I expected.
No.
This isn't Pantalone at all. No. I found you a new husband, yes, and this one is a prince. Huh? What do you say?
He looks kind of strange, but
yes,
I will take my chance.
Oh, good, perfect then. Yeah, Harlequin, do you happen to know how they perform weddings on the moon?
Oh, it's not a ceremony as much as it is a
party!
Well, it should be easier then, but. Still, you need someone to officiate, don't you? I mean, we don't have anyone.
Oh! Incredible!
Huh? The moon preacher is here!
The moon preacher is here too!
Moon
preacher!
They sent the moon preacher as well.
The moon preacher is with us tonight!
These people are really, really super organized.
You see, he's the moon preacher. We can recognize that because...
Yeah. Tell that, just from looking at it.
Yeah, he's very recognizable.
He's got hairy legs, but I'm not sure. Oh! Now I see it. Yeah.
Thank you.
ces années, à part de la Commedia, moi j'y connaissais rien.
C'est tellement cool.
Vous connaissez tout pour rien,
Maria. Je sais pour des années, pour...
Voilà. Alors, tu veux jamais... Mais... Ça passe ou ça casse?
Franchement, c'est...
Ouais.
C'est cool.
Mais, Nakondo, tu veux pas, toi, diriger la compagnie? Ce serait quand même vachement mieux si c'était toi.
Ouais.
Guy, I think you played on stage, and you should be on stage 24 hours, all the time, all day, all the time on stage. You should be only on stage. Mm. And so I can handle the myself. Huh? What you said?
I be on stage all the time.
Yeah, all the time, 24/7.
My name is Big Ball Letter.
Big Ball Letter. Go.
Neon.
Any.
Okay, fine then. Yes. You can run the company, do all the shows, as long as... It's more conditional. As long as I can continue to do... Shakespeare. Psych! I was joking. Viva la Commedia! Created on purpose for this festival last year, as Frédéric explained. So I hope you enjoyed it, and tell all your friends if you did. If you didn't, don't tell anyone, of course. So all your friends, tell them we're doing it again in beautiful historical Palais Lascaris, just down the street, which is going to be about 20 degrees hotter than here. So you were very wise to come here today. And in any case, so spread the word, and we hope you enjoyed it. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much.
Un échange, vraiment une grande collaboration. Donc cette pièce a été créée surtout pour ce festival et on la joue encore samedi prochain au Palais Lascaris à 3h.
15h.
Merci
beaucoup. Merci
beaucoup.
Thank you.
Every night when that moon is big again.